Hello, welcome to Miniature Realms. Time for a quick review of another Sarissa Precision MDF product. So if you've seen some of the other unboxing stroke reviews on the channel, you'll know that I'm building lots of stuff from their American Civil War 15mm range. Some of it was launched with the Epic Battles starter set by Warlord Games. So the new Warlord Games Epic Battles American Civil War. 13.5mm Warlord Game stuff is close enough to 15mm, so Sarissa have made some things for them, and then they continue the line themselves. And then they released a Antietam battle set or battle pack for $32.50, and with that you get the Dunker's Church model, you get a North American covered bridge, you get some snake fencing, and you also get this three arch stone bridge. Now this is obviously from an existing kit. This is the first one that's not branded with the new Sarissa Precision logo, and also the North American 15mm range stuff. But I got it as part of the Antietam kit. You can obviously purchase it on its own. So I'm still going to give you a quick review of it, and if you're interested in the other bits, go and check those out on the channel. So, as with all Sarissa Precision stuff that I've had, you do get pretty decent instructions. These aren't quite as nicely presented as the newer printed stuff they have, but this is obviously an older kit. Still looks like it's fairly straightforward and shouldn't be too hard to follow. And it looks like the kit comes in different sections, so you can make it into a one arch or a triple arch, and I think when you purchase it, you can also purchase it so it becomes a double arch as well. So let's have a little look at the bits. So you have some thinner carb bits. These are obviously so you can bend them. And there's your curved arches ready to bend them around. So looks a little bit different to some of the other MDF kits I've built, which are all angles. So it'll be interesting to see how this works. I'm also someone that usually builds my MDF kits with super glue. And I'm not so sure that's going to work with this more card related stuff. That'll be interesting. I'm not going to put you through watching me do it and any swearing that happens, so I will cut away now. I'll come back with the kit all built. And here we are. So this one took me a little bit longer, probably took me about half an hour to build. The cardboard edging is a little bit fiddly, especially when you're stubborn like me and wanted to use super glue, so it's all ready to film straight afterwards. But it's definitely doable. You just have to be a little bit precise and be quite quick. It's a little bit different to the others. So when I looked at the kit, I didn't really realise that there wasn't really going to be any support for the cardboard pieces, which means it's a fairly stable structure. But I'd be a little bit concerned about this taking paint, so I'll have to be careful that I don't soak it. I'm worried about this moment warp. It may well be a particular kind of card that doesn't do that. I don't know. Looks like the kit's been around for a while, so if they're still selling it, there can't be too many issues with it. But it looks good, no problem with it at all. So as I say, you can have it in the three arch style, or you can make it a single arch bridge. And when you buy them on their own, on the Sarissa website, you can buy it as a single arch bridge, you can buy it as a double, or you can buy it as a triple. So pretty useful. Once you've covered all this in flock or texture and things, I think it'll look really, really good. And the cardboard trim does add enough detail, I think, as well. I think it will paint up very well, and the painted examples on their website make it look great. So that's the positive side. I think the kit's great. Negatives. I think it's too big. So it's advertised on the website in part of their 15mm range as a 15mm stone bridge triple arch set, and I'll pop the image on the screen now. It's £10.50, which I think is value's fine, absolutely fantastic. I think it's clearly was designed for 28mm. The instructions give that away a little bit, and then when you get your miniatures on it, you can see that. So the other buildings from this range have been scaled to the miniatures. So scaled to sort of proper 15mm miniatures rather than abstracting, which is the only thing to do, I think. And you'll find a lot of people playing Epic Battles opting for 10mm terrain, which looks nearly right, Looks fine on the table, but it just decreases that footprint a little bit too, so that you can have a larger a scale on your table, so you can get a lot more battle in on a 6x4, so to speak. Now, fits a whole stand of Epic Scale inventory there, so that's a 60mm base, so probably looking at 75mm space width. I mean, that's fine in one sense because they can walk up there like that, but it's, if it's supposed to be the Burnside Bridge or any of the other bridges on the Antietam battlefield, it would be too wide scale wise, at least by double. I'll pop a little picture of real Burnside Bridge up there now on the screen. You can see how narrow it actually was. Now, I've got a smaller resin one, not at hand, but I do have a smaller resin one, which is three arch as well, which in terms of scale on the battlefield will probably do a better job. However, the negatives of that is that I'd have to turn these sideways to go over it. So, you know, rough with the smooth. At least this is wide enough to take the stand. So in terms of playing the game, it will work fine. And I imagine that's why they've gone down the route of repurposing this stuff and setting it as 15mm. There will have been bridges that would have been this scale, this size within 15mm. So I'm not saying it's the wrong scale, but in terms of placing within that Antietam battle set, it seems a little bit too big in that sense, really. But it's absolutely fine. I mean, look, it's big enough that you could drive a truck over it. So this will become a bit more multi-purpose for me. So that's the benefit of it, I suppose. I'll paint it up in a generic way and it'll just become a bridge that I use for multiple different game systems. So, you know, there's nothing negative about it in terms of its size. I'm not too worried. I bought the Antietam battle set, partly out of interest, really, because I already had a Dunker's Church to use. I've already mentioned in the previous video when I reviewed the Dunker Church that it's, I think the scale's absolutely fine for the miniatures. I'm aiming towards something a bit closer to the 10mm scale, and even those vary quite wildly. A little bit too large a footprint for some of the games I play. However, when I play smaller games with just a few brigades aside, then this terrain will definitely come into effect. So it's not useless. I do like it. It's not a negative thing, but it's not quite what I expected when I looked at the pictures on the website, not knowing the rest of Sarissa's World War range. If I did, maybe if I've been playing bolt action for a few years and I was familiar with that range, and I had some more of it, I'd have recognised this and realised that it was, you know, originally a probably designed for 28mm scale, and I'd have known that it would be a bit larger, so I expected this to be a little bit smaller. But it's a good kit, nothing wrong with the kit. I just think it's a little bit big to be Burnside Bridge, if that's what they were aiming for. Anyway, thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe and all that other stuff. If you're into your American Civil War, Epic Scale or even 15mm stuff, there's loads and loads of videos on the channel relating to that. There's other things covered as well, a bit of bolt action, a few other game systems, and that will continue to grow. So thanks again and I'll catch you soon.